Good morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, and the love of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
Amen.
In the waters of baptism, Sister Miriam George died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. God of all grace. Blessing, source of all holiness, the voice of your Spirit has drawn countless men and women to follow Jesus Christ and to bind themselves to you with ready will and loving heart. Look with mercy on Sister Miriam George, who sought to fulfill her vows to you, and grant her the reward promised to all good and faithful servants. May she rejoice in the company of the saints and with them praise you forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples. The web that is woven over all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day, it will be said, behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we've looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we also await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. He will change our lowly body to conform with his glorified body by the power that enables him also to bring all things into subjection to himself. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee. but he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to ask him questions. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arm around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Father Joseph Devlin. I'm the pastor of St. Matthew's in Conshohocken. But my real claim to fame is I was taught by Sister George in the first grade 55 years ago at St. Anselm. And collecting my thoughts for today, I was thinking back, I do have some memories of first grade. For example, I remember Sister George teaching all of us that we have a soul. And then she colored in part of the circle that she had drawn on the board. And then she erased that filled in part and said, "That's what God's forgiveness does to our soul. He washes us clean." I also remember drill and mental. Up and down the rows, too slow, pass, right? But what I mostly remember is that we sang all the time. Whether it was we were moving from, say, spelling time to math time, we had a song for each of those change of subjects. And since we ate at our desks for lunch, Sister was with us, you know, during lunch, she played a record player. And of course, it played the whole period if it was a rainy day. So to this day, whenever I hear certain songs like Frank Sinatra's Summer Wind, Peter, Paul, and Mary's Leaving on a Jet Plane, I remember all 60-some of us singing along, and I'm taken right back to Sister George's first grade classroom, grade one, room one, and remember her fondly. As my mom would say, since Sister taught three of her five kids, every child should have the privilege of having Sister George as a teacher in first grade. That's because she was not only a good teacher, but she created a happy atmosphere in her classroom where children could enjoy learning. And I was thinking as we were coming in, not to draw attention to the mom, but wouldn't Miriam George love the fact that there was a baby fussing, right, in church today? She would love that. She would make that baby the most important person here, right? She loved children. What she did, if I'm correct, Sister sent me her curriculum vitae. She taught little kids for 53 years between parish schools and then being out here at Immaculata with the early childhood kindergarten school. This was Sister Miriam George's mission, welcoming little ones in the Lord's name, to quote our gospel, serving the Lord by loving and teaching little children. And she no doubt believed the famous line from literature, "A teacher affects eternity. She can never tell where her influence stops." Since meeting up again with Sister George in the early 90s as a priest, I was always struck by two qualities she always seemed to radiate: joy and gratitude. Sister George was joyful. As many of you know, in that beautiful handwriting of hers, that's how she would always close out her notes or cards, joyfully. She was positive energy, She was joyful. While I know she may not have always been herself in these last few years, but Miriam George always had an enthusiasm for life, for people, and for the mission. That was certainly an education after all those decades. But also, wherever you went with Sister George, she smiled, greeted people, and talked to everybody as you made your way, if you were going to a cafe for lunch. She was always keenly aware that she was representing the community, the church, and the Lord. She was always on mission. Sister George was always so grateful. Grateful for her vocation, for the IHM community, for the people she worked with at the university, for the families she became friends with over the years, for all her experiences as a teacher, for summers assisting at Stone Harbor. She loved the shore, right? Joy and gratitude. Where did such good, beautiful qualities come from? Or what fed her joy and gratitude? Or better, who fed her joy and gratitude? The answer, of course, is the Lord Jesus Christ, the one who called Elizabeth Kelly to religious life. The Lord calls, but as we all know, we must decide to respond to say yes, not once, but each day of our lives. And the more wholehearted our yes, the more we find life, fullness of life, the more we know joy, and we realize that in spite of it all, what a great gift we've been given, and gratitude can grow. But it takes our daily yes, our daily surrender, a letting go, to be sure. Surrender and letting go to 21st century America typically sounds like losing. But Jesus in the gospel and religious by their vows declare the abundant life is found in the surrender to Christ each day. And by working at penetrating what Benedict XVI referred to as the logic of the gospel. Sister Miriam George knew, and in fact all faithful, believing, praying Catholics know, it's only when we surrender ourselves to Jesus in love and in service to others that we win. The logic of the gospel is to always be eager to love like the child the Lord holds up for us in today's gospel by making ourselves small, loving in an uncomplicated way, in a generous way, forgetting ourselves. We can come to know joy and gratitude. Daily prayer, daily Mass, daily looking for her Savior, looking at her Savior, to echo our first reading, all help Sister Miriam George to say yes each day of her life. And because of her generous yeses, the Lord gifted her with joy and gratitude. And now we commend our dear Sister Miriam George, Georgie, Betty Kelly, to the Lord today, after nearly 97 years of life. Of course, we're saddened by her passing. In my name, in the name of the priest and Deacon Jack, Father John Berger, Father Michael Greco, Father Tom Viviano, who was also taught by Sister Miriam George in first grade at St. John Bosco, I extend to Sister's family and friends, nieces, nephews, my condolences to you on the loss of someone so very deeply loved. We will all miss her. May all of us find consolation in our belief that death for the Christian is not the end of existence. The deepest hope nourished by the faith is the final encounter with Christ when we die. For we are citizens of heaven, as St. Paul reminds us in our second reading. As it's our belief that Sister Miriam George's soul is now born to eternal life, reunited with her parents, Elizabeth and George, George, her brother, her dear friend, Sister James Anthony, all deceased IHMs and loved ones and friends who have gone before her. But most especially, with the Lord Jesus Christ, who now gives her joyful and grateful soul the fullness of life for all eternity. We now offer prayers of petition with confidence in our loving Father.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. That the bishops and priests of the church and all who preach the gospel may be given the strength to express in action the word they proclaim, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer. That those in public office may promote justice, peace, and the common good, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer. That those who bear the cross of pain in mind, body, or spirit will know the peace of Christ's sustaining presence, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer. That Sister Miriam George may be reunited in the joy and peace of heaven this day with her parents and all those she has loved and lost in this life, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer. That those who mourn the loss of Sister Miriam George, her family, her friends, the Sisters of Immaculata University, and the Sisters in our band may be comforted, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer. That God may welcome into his glory the deceased members of Sister Miriam George's family, especially her parents, George and Elizabeth, and her brother, George, we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, creator and redeemer of all the faithful, grant to the souls of the departed servants release from all sins. Hear our prayers for those who love, we love, and give them the pardon they have always desired. We ask these things in the name of Jesus, our risen Lord, now and forever.
Amen.
My soul doth glory in your love, O Lord. My soul doth glory in your love, O Lord.
Please stand and pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant, Sister Miriam George, may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by this same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. George and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant, Sister Miriam George, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand and let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant, Sister Miriam George, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our sister Miriam George has fallen asleep in Christ. Confident in our hope of eternal life, let us commend her to the loving mercy of our Father, and let our prayers go with her. She was adopted as God's daughter in baptism and was nourished at the table of the Lord. May she now inherit the promise of eternal life and take her place at the table of God's children in heaven. Let us pray also on our own behalf that we who now mourn and are saddened may one day go forth with our sister to meet the Lord of life when he appears in glory. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Miriam George in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. In peace, let us take our sister Miriam George to her place of rest.
Lift up your hearts, O daughters of Our Lady. Praise ye the love divine. Dwelling now in night, yet ever. keep.